Morning, everyone.
Hi.
It's Monday morning, so we're headed off on another adventure. We've got a carload of disc golf discs as well. We're selling those later on. But in the meantime, we're going to go thrifting in a couple of small towns along the way. So we'll see you when we get there. Morning, everyone. We're in my favourite town in all of southeast Queensland. This is the Halloween capital of the area. This town is called Boo.
Nah.
Yeah, it's Boo. It's right there on the sign.
Nah.
Ah, Boona. Ah, we're in Boona. You know anything about Boona, Carmen?
It's a small country town.
Well, they got three op shops. And they must have something to do with a rock-solid Boona.
And trains.
So there's all trains and stuff. I'll see if I can step back a little bit, but we're going to head into Boona and hit up their three op shops. So hopefully there's some good stuff here.
Hey.
Let's get in there. Brisbane, about 2 hours north of us. I'll pop the map up on the screen and show where we are. But this is one of the areas that when we moved a bit south, we had a look here, but just for the size of the land we wanted, there was just nothing in our price range.
No. It was a bit expensive.
But it is a good distance, you know, for people to travel down just for a weekend.
Do you want me to go there?
Yeah, that's right. Salvo, open. Oh, a nice big war monument too. Jeez. And there it is on the right. So this place just reopened today. Lucky us. Half price shoes. This is another one we've never been to before. Where are you going to start, Val? Quite a big one. Oh, geez, it keeps going. It's a massive one. There's still in that same shop. It keeps going and going and going. Let's see if there's anything in the toys. Holy shit. That's the stuff. Put it into the backpack already.
Do you want to hold that
okay
one?
And just want to have a look at that Pac-Man game there. Sorry, I thought yeah.
That wind. Fine, it's okay.
I was packing up the frisbees yesterday and stuff went everywhere. It was windy, but I needed to do it.
This one does actually work. We've got 100 on that one. It's a collectible.
Oh, okay.
Okay.
So we did go online, they got one for $2.50.
That's not a reprint or anything, is it? Is it?
It'll probably be here if we come back, Mark.
I don't know, but what if I want it now? I'm just trying to work out if it's... There's only the one date on there, isn't there? That's...
I believe someone said to us, the sound. When you turn it on, the sound is what gives it away if it's a reproduction or not.
Okay.
I don't know.
Oh no, I suppose.
Use battery.
No, it's all lit up, I just don't know how to.
There. So that's really old and computery, you know. Yeah.
And here it is, guys. Thought I'd interject and show you that beautiful Pac-Man game. So it did cost me $100. But if you have a look here. I'm probably going to take the battery out soon because they have batteries in it to test it. 1981. So it was a gamble. I didn't even bother to look it up. I thought, no, that's years and years of doing this. I've not seen one of these. And... oh, so where I think it's... What is the demo? Not flashing like that on the screen here, it's just because of the way cameras work and capturing light. But yeah, that's him there. Pac-Man by Midway. I don't know why it turned off though.
I don't think this has changed much this trip.
So we're walking around downtown Boona. We're finding that a lot of stuff is closed today. I think it's more that way. Down.
It's a show holiday.
I'm going to look up the desert stores and see if we're going to waste our time or not. Come on, phone.
From. Want a drink?
Sure. Okay, well, our trip to Boone is going to be a very short one because only one op shop is open. Okay, well, we'll go have a look. Maybe that lady was misinformed. I've
message her back and say, are you married? And she'll say, no, that's correct because you're misinformed. Rockalicious ice cream and sweets. Butcher. So we picked a good day to come here. It's all closed. Vinny's now.
That breeze is very icy, isn't it?
We are open. Come on in and warm up. I'm good. It's a bit. I've got my jumper on still. I'm quite okay. That's pretty good for a wild turkey, temper. I don't know about this one-way street though for a main street. It's it just makes it too confusing when you want to get somewhere. Smith Gun Through Arcade. Oh, that arcade maybe. Okay, so that's a big giant sign out the front. Let's see what happens here.
Looky,
looky. You want to put that in my bag then? I don't want to carry it around. So yeah, this one is open.
I just put it in there.
I think we might only get to Boona today, Dale.
Okay.
I don't want to be frantic. I'm going to cut in right here. Like, you just saw that rack over there on the wall with all the bright colors and all that. It took me a while to get around to that, but when I did, I pulled out, I've got it all in front of me. I'm going to show you right now. I pulled out 10 plus items from that one amazing rack. I couldn't believe it. Like, Adidas Predator shirt with the tag. Like, awesome. Bubba Gump Shrimp, Cancun. Couldn't believe I found this at like a Boona op shop. Johnny Gargano, WWE, what do they call this? Like an acid wash shirt. Insane. This is the Helensvale Rugby Club from Gold Coast. So just a nice solid rugby jersey. I love having those on my shop. This, I've struggled with some of them, but I always pick them up when I see them. So this is Ford Performance Racing. So it's just a V8 supercars type shirt. This one here is the GPS rugby. I should know who that is, but I'll look it up and I might put it on the screen if I remember. But this club is established in 1887, so I think it's one of the main rugby clubs in Brisbane. I don't know where I saw it, but I read something about the Beaverton Nike stuff. So this is a Beaverton Nike shirt. So I got a feeling that, you know, just for the price, it was worth it. We ended up spending like $210 at this shop. Here we've got, this is a battle worn, battle to the end, Battleship Missouri for Pearl Harbor. So a souvenir shirt on a Hanes tag. I think it's not vintage or anything, but yeah, just a good look. Something you wouldn't see very often here in Australia. This Korean Football Association. All those pops of red and orange and blue and all that, this is what they all were. I could, just amazing. Yeah, I've sold plenty of this stuff. Fox Motorsports or Fox Racing. So yeah, this is a pretty nice what do they call it, dry fit type shirt. Like, very happy with that one. Oh wait, there's the exact same one in orange with a tag as well. And these are nice big sizes too. These are double XL Fox Ranger, they're called. But brand new with a tag. Let's see if there's a price on this guy. Now, someone paid $59.99 for that. I think I paid $8. So that should be nice, easy money. This is a New South Wales, so ADFBA basketball jersey from 2013. Love this sort of regional stuff. So New South Wales regional basketball jersey. And this is the same thing, so it must have been the same person. This is like the shirt, you know, warm-up shirt that they'd wear. So, yeah, love that stuff. Love anything regional. I've got two things left. What's the better one to wait? Oh, yeah, I'll save that one to last. This one here, Tommy Bahama. Bit plain, but we don't see much of it here in Australia, so I thought I'd give it a go for that price. And they had four Gantt shirts in a row that were all different colours. They were $10 each. I thought, I'm not selling a lot of Gantt, so I didn't take the risk, but they were very tempting, like four of them in a row. But this last thing, whew. Cue the fire treatment for this guy. KFC Big Bash. Is it Big Bash? No, it's just a KFC Australia jersey. Someone's written their name on the tag. Everything was small though. That's the only, I like, well, not everything, but like the good stuff was all small. But yeah, so an Australian cricket team jersey, I'll call it. So, so yeah, that one awesome rack was awesome. So now I'll show you the video of me heading out the back. Oh, that vintage goodness. They got my tubs. Okay, that was a pretty good stop there at Vinny's. We had to actually move the car. We still got all our mail on us because post office wasn't open.
So it's a public holiday here for their royal show or their local show day.
I think it's the Echo one is everywhere and it was cancelled. This is all related to the Brisbane Echo.
All right.
So later on we'll go through, maybe later on tonight, we'll dump it all into the room and go through everything we got, but $408 spent in two stores, but some good stuff, some really more men's than women's as usual.
Mm-hmm.
That's, you know, I'm doing the bulk of the selling at the moment, so but
straight,
yeah, you can talk. I'm gonna put it in the map.
Yes, please.
Just gonna beeline straight. I've got many pockets. I've got two different phones on me, got my wallet.
There's a nice clock up here. You know, when we walked through that little park area earlier?
Yeah, I filmed it a little bit. Oh. Someone was trying to call me.
It's up high right there. It's a metal clock made out of bits and bobs.
Perhaps.
There's not much down this way. Drive-through bottle shops.
Just the town centre itself is just nice. Like ours is just the one street and traffic light, whereas this is a bit like villagey.
Shops.
It's more village than town.
It is.
Okay, so it's saying to turn right out of here.
Oh, right.
Oh, no, I'm left, sorry. Left.
Left and then right.
That just popped up. You can see the nice big, when we turn the corner, you'll see the nice big booner, and then we'll sign off, and next time you see us, hopefully be us going through all of our. I like the houses up on the hill here. That must be like the cherry on the hill. It's like this random big slope, and they're all up there.